Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll be learning how to draw the demand curve only being given the demand equation. With that said, let's get into it. So first things first, in order to draw the demand curve, I'm going to need myself some graph paper. And with that, I'm going to label a general supply and demand curve, starting with the axes, labeling those axes price and quantity. And then of course, I will need the actual demand equation itself. In this video, the demand equation is Q is equal to 128 minus 4P, but obviously this could be any demand equation that you're given. I can tell by looking at this equation that I'm looking at a linear demand curve just because that is a Y equals MX plus B general form line. So now that I have a general supply and demand curve drawn, as well as my demand equation, I can now start labeling this demand curve to actually make it represent the equation that I'm given. And I'm going to start by labeling these two points right here. This is the price intercept and the quantity intercept, also known as the Y and X intercepts. So to calculate the Q intercept or the X intercept, I'm going to rewrite my original demand equation. So QD is equal to 128 minus 4P. Now, if I'm looking for the x-intercept, then I know that the y value must be zero. And in this case, the y is p, or price. And so I'm going to sub in a value of zero for p. Because at any point on the x-axis, or the quantity axis, I know that price must be equal to zero. Simplifying further, I get 128 minus zero, which is just 4 times zero. And then finally, qd must be equal to 128. So now I can label that on my actual graph. And I'm going to do the exact same thing, but now for the y-axis or the price axis. So I'm going to rewrite my general demand equation, but this time instead of letting p equal zero, I'm now going to let q equal zero, because any point on the y-axis, the x value must be equal to zero. So this time I sub in q equals zero and then I solve. Rearranging, I'll get 4p is equal to 128. And then of course I need to get p all by itself, so I'm going to divide both sides of the equal sign by 4. This yields me a value of 32 for p, and then I can go ahead and sub this in on my graph as well. So sometimes your prof or your teacher will say that this is good enough. This is a labeled demand curve. It has your price intercept and your quantity intercept. However, some teachers will ask that you have multiple points labeled on the graph as well. So we're going to show you how to do that. You know that for a demand curve that looks like this, the maximum price is 32 and the maximum quantity is 128. And you know that just by looking at the intercepts. That means that you could take any price from 0 to 32 and find its corresponding quantity. You could also take any quantity from 0 to 128 and find its corresponding price. Let me show you how it's done. Suppose we choose a price, $24. And we want to know the corresponding value on the q-axis, or the corresponding quantity. How do I go about solving that? Well, instead of subbing in a price of 0, I'm going to sub in a price of 24, since I know that the price is 24. Solving further, I'll have q is equal to 128 minus 96, and then simplifying further, qd is equal to 32. So now I can label that point on my demand curve as well, 32 and 24. I can also do this if I want to choose a Q value and solve for the corresponding P value. Let's see how to do that. So suppose I have a Q value of 80, and I want to see what the corresponding P value is. Well, I'm going to rewrite the original equation, and now I don't know P, but I do know Q. So I'm going to sub in the new value for Q, which is 80. Upon doing this, I get a line that looks like 80 is equal to 128 minus 4P. Rearranging this equation with the hopes to isolate P, I get 4P is equal to 128 minus 80. Simplifying further, I get 4P equals 48. And again, I want to isolate P, so I will divide both sides by 4, which is going to give me a value of 12 for P. I can now write this on my graph as well. So now I actually have 4 points on this demand curve, but I don't necessarily need to stop there. There's plenty of other points that I haven't gone over on this demand curve, and they all have corresponding Q and P values. I could plug each of them individually into this demand equation and find the corresponding values, and then I could also make a table of values or a demand schedule to actually look at all of these values in one given place. Even with all of the values I have on the table right now, this is not an exhaustive list. In fact, you could find an infinite number of values between a price of 0 and a price of 32, as well as between a quantity of 0 and a quantity of 128. The possibilities are endless. You just need to sub them in to the demand equation and then solve for the other value. I hope that this video helped you understand how the demand equation and how the demand curve are linked to one another, and that you understand both of them more thoroughly after watching this video. If you enjoyed the video, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and of course, comment in the comment section what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.